They want ministers to understand the depth of the problem and the scale of the problem. And interestingly, the numbers of victims are not that high. But for the individuals concerned, this is a matter which is really impacting their mental health, which has a knock-on effect on their physical well-being. We've seen relationships break down. We've seen attempted suicides. And all because really despicable people defrauded them of their life savings. And we don't want the government to then pursue them for tax amounts that they simply cannot pay.
Might your proposal set a dangerous precedent for you? I'm sorry with your people. You haven't said in defrauded. We can't let them on tax. They owe, and these people owe this tax, however unfair that might seem.
The fundamental issue is that these people's savings were stolen. They're being charged with tax liability on money that they have not seen for years and years and have no hope of recovering, and in some instances have no hope of earning any money to pay that tax. The stark reality is it can well cost more to pursue these individuals than the Treasury could ever hope to recover. We're asking for a pragmatic solution that looks at the individual cases separately and takes into account their individual circumstances and shows a bit of compassion towards them and recognising that they're the victims of crime. These are not people who set out to defraud HMRC. They were the victims of the forces.
Caroline Noakes, MP.
My article, Paris,
got a 6-month pause in being chased for tax would mean to
her.
You still have to pay the bills.
It's tough. It is so, so tough.
Firefighter Russ Ferris. The Treasury told us, we sympathise with people who may have lost money by entering such arrangements. We take the well-being of all taxpayers seriously and recognise that dealing with large tax liabilities comes with significant pressure. Our message to anyone who's worried about a tax liability is to contact HMRC as soon as possible. Talk about options. It added, we do not tax pension savings lost before. What we do tax are amounts that people release from their pensions where not authorised in law. Which can, of course, as with Russ, the pension savings lost before. Campaigners are due to meet the Treasury again in February. We will, of course, keep you up to date with developments. Working parents of two-year-olds are struggling to get a code they need to register for 15 hours a week of subsidised childcare in term time, which begins in England in April. There are also reports of technical glitches and staff shortages. Moneybox reporter Sarah Rogers is with us. And Sarah, you reported on this new scheme earlier this month when parents and nurseries began to report difficulties. Where are we now?
So this is a story, it's still unfolding with a number of interviews. So firstly, this is how it should be. Working parents need childcare, they can find the details, and this reduces the code, which parents give to the childcare provider to process. But some listeners got in touch with us to say that they were worried that they wouldn't get their credit time because they couldn't reconfirm the details until the end of March. And the funding round was beginning on April 1st, so clearly worried they were coming a little bit close. And then that's the Department of Education for a few weeks ago, and they told me it was investigating and working on a solution. Now the government has acknowledged it remains an issue and says it will start sending parents to all to parents next month.
Expressed in Parliament this week, weren't there, about the number of staff who will be needed for these extra children?
Yes, Labour's Shadow Minister Florence Escheloni asked Government Minister responsible, which is David Johnston, about a report that tens of thousands of additional early years staff will be needed this year as the scheme expands. He agreed more staff were needed, and the Department for Education told me a nationwide recruitment campaign will be